we have made it to session 6 of the professionalism of collegiate music recruiting. Each of our sessions has been led by Dr. Stephen Moore, the Associate Dean of Undergraduate Studies at the University of Miami Frost School of Music. Let's go join Dr. Moore now for his closing remarks. Dr. Moore, we have spent a great deal of time really drilling in all of the details of music recruiting. But now I'd like to ask you, what are the big takeaways? What are the things that we should take with us as we move forward?
Well, Clark, I've really appreciated working with you. And of course, when you're thinking about communications, appreciation is always a good way to begin. And it's important to keep in mind the question that all, you know, that you're thinking about with your communications with people and that audience. Why should they care? You want to be you-oriented in your language and use evocative, picturesque words that are very positive and also positive images. We want to have a strong yet concise message about our value proposition and what makes us unique. It's always good if you can meet objections in advance. If you know that cost may be a deterrent, lead with how your school can address that. Obviously, it doesn't do any good to recruit a student and then not be able to afford to attend your school. And if there's a reputation associated with a program or a school, we want to bust that myth early on. And mostly, we want to encourage students to join our family. People want to be part of something that's bigger than themselves.
Yeah, what an important key, joining that collegiate family. You know, I have to ask you, what are some of the key challenges and choices and decisions that students are having to make?
Well, students are certainly a lot more informed than they used to be. They are going to choose based on the applied faculty, particularly performance majors, very smart, while others are more interested in the ensembles of a school. And some students choose based on the specialty or reputation of a particular program or major, such as music therapy, education, composition, music engineering, or business. Some are maybe more swayed by the overall reputation of the school and the faculty. And many are guided by their teacher recommendation, both their school ensemble directors or their private lesson teachers.
Yeah, I know that it's important to consider that what students are seeing around them is going to play a part in their decision. I had lots of friends that had made their choice of where they were going to go to school by 10th grade because that's where their friends were going or where their family had gone.
Right. Of course, the peer group is very important. But students often are going to have a comfort level with the university and even just the facilities. You know, it's not always easy for them to evaluate a curriculum, but you know what they can see? They're going to immediately notice the studios and the rehearsal rooms and the classrooms, the dormitories, and the food courts.
That makes sense. That's the first thing you're going to see. And I know that for some students as well, the location matters. You know, oftentimes they want to go to New York City or Chicago, big cities. But for myself, I actually ended up staying at home because that was where I felt most comfortable.
You know, and what a great decision for you, because the best school in the country for that particular student is the one that's a good fit for them, where they feel comfortable, but yet they're challenged. And so, yes, students are often attracted by a particular city, the music scene in the area, the location, the weather, the culture. And almost always, students and parents are going to consider the economics and the affordability. But perhaps one of the most important reasons that students are going to choose is that they feel wanted and that they have a sense that they are going to be a vital part of the musical, academic, and social community.
That's the key right there, is making sure that students feel wanted. How important.
Right. So with that in mind, I hope all the faculty out there and all the recruiters and everyone involved in this process are going to feel very comfortable asking for a student to commit, deposit, and enroll at their school. I mean, we must believe in ourselves and our programs and the power of music enough to know that we do a young person a favor when we recruit them. They want to follow their passion, and we want to give them the tools to do it. Because it's our passion too. We want to enable students to have the artistic, academic, and emotional tools to thrive in today's world. We want students to be able to earn a living and to live a life worth living.
Oh, I love that. I love that, to have students be able to earn a living and to have a life worth living. I think that's a motto that every recruiter should take with them.
Well, Clark, thank you. And Much appreciation and thanks to the good folks at scholarshipauditions.com for sponsoring these sessions. Here's hoping every music recruiter has a very successful recruiting class. And please feel free to connect with me if I can be of any service to you as you implement the professionalism of collegiate music recruiting.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Moore, for all of your time and experience. It's been so helpful and wonderful. And with that, this is the conclusion of Session 6 of the Professionalism of Collegiate Music Recruiting.